Hi, are you looking to stay ahead of the competition and create cutting-edge language models for your organization? Do you want to leverage the latest techniques and best practices for training large language models? You're in the right place. Best practices for developing LLMs in-house, inspired by the experiences of the Bloomberg GPT team. In this series, we'll provide practical guidance and insights for senior executives, managers, developers, and others involved in seeking to develop and deploy their own large language models for their firm. And I hope that AI and machine learning enthusiasts will find this insightful too, as we look at some of the more practical factors in deploying AI models. By following these best practices, you can accelerate your team's ability to create high-quality models and stay at the forefront of AI and NLP. So don't miss out on this opportunity to learn from the experience of other successful deployments and transform your organization's language modeling capabilities. As ever, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe if you want to be notified when the next videos in this series drop. In this video, we'll be taking a closer look at the successes and experiences of the Bloomberg GPT team, who recently developed a 50 billion parameter language model for the financial services industry. We'll explore some of the key insights that they gained during the development process and highlight how these can be applied to your own language model development projects. This video also serves as an introduction to this series, Best Practices for Developing In-House Large Language Models. We'll describe each of the key topics today, and then subsequent videos will dive into detail for each area. The areas we will address in this video and the following series are as follows: data and data pipelines, data tokenization and transformation, choosing the right model architecture, evaluation and success criteria. Finally, shape of the model and choice of hyperparameters. One of the key lessons learned from the Bloomberg GPT project is the importance of domain-specific data. The team constructed a 363 billion token dataset based on Bloomberg's extensive data sources, perhaps the largest domain-specific dataset yet, augmented with a further 345 billion tokens from general purpose datasets. This mixed dataset training approach led to a model that outperformed existing models on financial tasks by significant margins without sacrificing performance on general large language model benchmarks. So when developing your own language model, be sure to prioritize domain-specific data sources for optimal performance. Tokenization is a fancy word for breaking down a piece of text, like a sentence or a paragraph, into smaller parts called tokens. These tokens can be words, phrases, even individual letters. The reason we do this is because computers need to understand human language in order to do things like translate languages or analyze sentiment in social media posts. By breaking down text into tokens, we can help computers understand the meaning behind what people are saying. Think of it like building with Lego, just like how we can build different things by putting Lego bricks together in different ways. Computers can understand different meanings by putting together different tokens. You can make tokens out of whole words, but it's often more efficient to use subword tokenization. Subword tokenization exploits the fact that words are made up of primitives that provide consistent modifiers, such as the table on your screen. Tokenization is a critical step in the language model development process that is often overlooked. Bloomberg GPT used its own unigram model instead of an off-the-shelf tokenizer, since it saves probabilities, allowing for smarter tokenization at inference time. Unigram is a subword tokenizer, which is useful for handling rare words, allowing the model to guess or understand the meaning of a rare word. This is very useful in finance with lots of jargon and compound words. This approach was found to be more efficient than other tokenizers, so consider testing different tokenization strategies to find the one that works best for your particular use case. Another critical lesson learned from Bloomberg GPT is that model sizing matters. Bloomberg based their approach on the work of DeepMind's chinchilla team, who showed that for a given amount of computing operations, you could get better model performance by reducing the size of the model, that is to say, a model having fewer parameters, but increasing the size of the training data in terms of the number of tokens that make up the dataset. Here's the insight into the chinchilla results. Every large language model starts off with a budget. Most of that will be allocated to compute resources. With your budget, you're buying computing resources usually recorded as flops, floating point operations per second. To get more flops, you can use more GPUs, or you can shell out for more expensive GPUs. With your computing power, you can choose whether to build a bigger model or include more training data. Prior to the chinchilla results, conventional wisdom was to build the biggest model that you could afford given your budget. And this seemed to make sense. As models kept getting bigger, the performance kept getting better. But the chinchilla team challenged this. They ran experiments by training over 400 language models, ranging from 70 million to over 16 billion parameters on 5 to 500 billion tokens. They found that for compute optimal training, the model size and the number of training tokens should be scaled equally. For every doubling of model size, the number of training tokens should also be doubled. Using this approach, they were able to outperform models many, many times their size. They determined a set of heuristics, so-called chinchilla scaling laws, that advise on the optimum size of the model given the size of the training corpus and the available compute budget. Using these scaling laws from DeepMind, BloombergGPT produced a 50 billion parameter transformer to produce a system that's competitive, indeed outperformant of larger models. So the key takeaway is when designing your own language model, consider the size of the model in relation to the amount of training data available. Large language model evaluation remains a challenging and evolving problem, with new benchmarks trying to standardize evaluation across different approaches. However, for domain-specific tasks, there remains a mismatch between evaluation and actual use cases. Bloomberg GPT provided results on both public financial NLP benchmarks and a selection of internal Bloomberg tasks that most accurately reflected their intended use cases. When developing your own language model, consider your intended use cases carefully and ensure that your evaluation process accurately reflects these. So once the team arrived at a 50 billion parameter model, the team then had to determine the shape of their model, including how many attention heads, how many layers, and the optimal size for the hidden dimension. If these terms are new to you, don't worry, Lucidate has you covered. There are links at the end of this video to playlists describing these attributes of transformers. The table on your screen shows the key parameters of Bloomberg GPT. Remember as well that the Bloomberg team were predominantly solving problems that did not require use of an encoder block, meaning that all of the learnable parameters could be allocated to the decoder. In conclusion, the Bloomberg GPT team's experience in developing a 50 billion parameter language model for the financial services industry provides valuable insights into best practices for developing large language models generally. Domain-specific data, model sizing, tokenization, evaluation, and the training process are all critical considerations when developing a large language model. By taking these lessons learned into account and applying them to your own language model development projects, you increase your chances of a successful deployment. Please join me in the next videos in this series, where we dive into these concepts in more detail.